that as we grow, the hurdles will be more. Each time we are washed away, we bounce back to the shore. We know we lead the way, keeping odds at bay. See the sunrise tomorrow, inspire the world to follow. Our light is with the ASMR, from sea to Okay, I am Sumanto Kundu, Assistant Professor of Department of Electrical Engineering, Narula Institute of Technology. So, we are discussing the module number 2 in the course curriculum of electric drives EE701 on the topic selection of motor power rating. And today this is our second class on this topic selection of motor power rating. So we are going to start today's lecture, that is lecture number 6. Now before we proceed further into the subject, this is my course objective or outcome. Okay, so selection of motor power rating part 2. So we know that duty cycle are classified into various way. Among them, the three basic categories are continuous duty, fluctuating loads, and short time and intermittent duty. Now, what is continuous duty? Now, continuous duty is in which the power demand of the motor is ascertained. Power demand of the motor is known. Power demand of the motor is known. And so, if we know the power demand of the motor, so what we do, from the available, commercially available motors, and for every motors who is the manufacturer of the motor, they have a particular data sheet. So from that data sheet, what we will do, we will select the motor which has more power rating or higher power rating than that the demand of the motor. But when we are selecting from this data sheet, we should keep one thing in mind, that the motor speed should match the load speed requirement. And another thing, that motor should fulfill the starting torque requirement. Otherwise, the motor will fail to start with load. And we also keep into mind that we also have to keep one thing into mind, that it can continue to drive load in face of normal disturbance in power supply system. So if there is a power system supply disturbance occurs, but still it will able to drive the motor, and which is basically denoted as transient and steady state reserve torque capacity of the motor. Now we discuss equivalent current torque power method for fluctuating and intermittent load. Okay, now this is basically based on the approximation that the actual variable motor can be replaced by an equivalent current IEQ. I will replace the motor current rating through a equivalent current. So this is my concept using equivalent current method. And one thing also we have to keep in mind, that when we are approximating that the actual variable motor current can be replaced by equivalent current IEQ, but this IEQ produce the same losses which was produced the by the actual current. Okay, so this is my motto. Okay, now if we deduce mathematically, the equivalent current will become IEQ equals to root over of I1 square T1 plus I2 square T2 dot 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 IN square TN by T1 plus T2 up to TN. But this is nothing but the RMS value of the current. So, this is nothing but the root mean square value of the current. Okay. So, how mathematically we can deduce this? Let's check out. Okay. So, let's check out how we can mathematically deduce this. Okay. Sorry, just wait, some problem in the, let me check, one second. Sorry for the interruption, just matter of few seconds, just wait, let me open the PDF file. Okay. Okay, so now how we can mathematically deduce that equivalent current, that we will discuss here. Okay, so just wait a little bit more. So we have mentioned that in this method is based on the approximation that actual variable motor can be replaced by equivalent current IEQ, and also we have assumed that this equivalent current produces the same losses in the motor as the actual current. Now how this equivalent current determined? Now we know that motor loss P L consists of two components. One is PC, constant loss, and another one is PCU, variable loss. Okay. So one is constant loss, which is independent of the load, and under this category is becoming the core loss and frictional loss. And variable copper loss, that is my I square R loss, we know from our basic concept of electrical machine. Now, if the load is fluctuating load and it consists of n values of motor current from I1 to IN in the duration of T1 to TN, then what is we can write from the assumption? Just few minutes back, we have assumed that for the equivalent current IEQ, whatever losses will occur, that is same with the actual current. So what is the losses occur for equivalent current? It is constant loss Pc plus copper loss for that current, that is I square R loss, that is I square E2R. And what is the losses for fluctuating current, actual current? Now actual current are respectively I1, I2 in this fashion. Okay. So this is Pc I1 square R T1, then Pc I2 square R. The equivalent will not be here. It is wrong. So it is I1 square R1, I2 square Pc plus I2 square R into T2 dot 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 Pc into In square R Tn by T1 plus T2 total time. So the losses are equal. So from here we have done a little bit of simple mathematics of class 9-10. We have separated that part, Pc part and the I square R part. Means we have separated the constant losses part, and also we have separated the I square R losses part. So we can, if we separated these two parts, so it will be in the equation which has been shown here. Okay. Now, so you check that this T1, T2 up to Tn will cancel each other. So here the Pc will remain. So this Pc and this Pc will cancel each other. So from here this R and this R also will cancel each other. So what will remain? It will remain I square Eq equals to I1 square T1, I2 square T2 up to In divided by T1, T2 up to In. So what is my Iq? It is nothing but the root of this current. So this is my equivalent current. Okay. So this is my equivalent current. And this is nothing but the root mean square of the RMS value of the current. So I can write this equation as this I equivalent equals to 1 by root over of 1 by T 0 to 2 I square dt. This is our basic electrical concept of AC fundamental. But if the current varies smoothly over a period T, so the variation should be smooth. So this is my load diagram of fluctuating load, and this is another way to represent graphically the load diagram for fluctuating load. So now once I able to determine that I Eq, so what I will do now from the manufacturer data sheet, we will decide the next higher Kair rating from the data sheet. Means if IEQ equals to, suppose for say 10 ampere, so from data sheet I will select a motor of 12 ampere or 13 ampere or 11 ampere. Okay, then this rating is checked, is practically feasibilities. Okay, that is now suppose DC motor. Now I am checking the why it is whether practically possible or not. Suppose DC motor. Now we know that DC motor allowed to carry current larger than rated current for a short time period, and this is known as short time overload capacity of the motor. We have learned this is in our electrical machine. Now DC motor is designed to carry current about 2 times of the rated current, generally in the range of 1.5 to 2 times of the rated current. Okay, for special engine it can be 3 to 5 times of the rated current. Okay, now let's this maximum current means short time overload capacity of the motor we have assumed. Suppose it carry the 2 times of the rated current. So suppose the motor is 12, so it can carry maximum 24 ampere, and my rated current is 10 ampere. So then it is 20 ampere maximum current will draw, twice the rated current. Okay, so the lambda will become, the ratio will become 2. Okay, so this ratio of maximum allowable current to the rated current is lambda. Okay, now what I will do? So for above condition satisfied is not satisfying. If the above condition is not satisfied, means the lambda has to be greater than or equal to I max by I rated. Why? Because I got lambda equals to 2. Okay, let me clear it more. Sorry, let me clear it more. So we know the, I just told that suppose the rating of the motor, if the rating of the motor is 10 ampere, then we will select a motor in the rating of higher rating, suppose 12 ampere or 15 ampere in this fashion. Okay. Now what is my lambda? Lambda is the ratio of maximum current by rated current, maximum current by rated current. Now maximum current is twice the rated current, that is 20 ampere, and what is my rated current? 10 ampere. So lambda equals to 2. So this is nothing but the short time overloading capability of the motor. So this lambda has to be greater than or equal to this 2. So lambda can be 2 or greater than it. So lambda can be 3. Okay. So then only we will get the what is that? If this equation not satisfied, then the motor current is calculated from I rated equals to greater than equals to I max by lambda. From this equation I can write this. Okay, so from here we can determine I rated, because we know the value of lambda 2, we know maximum current 20 ampere. So I rated should be greater than equals to 10 ampere. So it should be in the range of 11 ampere or 12 ampere or 15 ampere. Okay. So this is, we got that I rated equals to I max greater than equals to I max by lambda. Now for induction motor and synchronous motor, the torque is the essential for synchronous motor and induction motor. The starting torque is very essential. So in this two motor, for stable operation, maximum torque T max should be less than equals to T breakdown. So it has to be satisfy this condition. Now when we have started induction motor, we have seen that for normal design, for induction motor, okay, the ratio of this T breakdown by T max will be 1.65 to 3. Suppose it is 2. That is, T breakdown equals to 2 into T max. Okay. And for special type of motor, it is in the range of up to 3.5. In case of synchronous motor, it is 2 to 2.5. So, similarly, the way we have determined the I rated, similar condition is also applicable for this. The lambda dash should be greater than equals to T max by T rated. So if this condition does not satisfy, so how I will get T rated? I will get T rated from this equation. T rated equals to greater than equals to T max by lambda dash. Okay. So this is my equivalent torque method. Okay. Now equivalent constant current method, we have assumed losses, constant losses remain constant for all operating period. Therefore, this method should be carefully employed where there are loss varying, because we have assumed throughout the operation, whether it is determination of I equivalent, whether it is determination of T equivalent, we have assumed the constant losses P, that is the core loss and friction losses same. But it can be the application where it is not true. So it is not applicable for the motor with frequency dependent parameter of the equivalent circuit. For example, deep bar and double cage squirrel cage motor, where the rotor winding and resistance vary widely during starting and braking. Okay, so this is we know from our electrical machine concept. So when now well, for DC machine we have known the torque is proportional to IA. For DC series motor, torque is proportional to IA square. Actually DC is T is proportional to phi IA. So whether it is induction motor, for induction motor torque is proportional to current. Current term will definitely is there. Okay. It is voltage into current into the power factor for induction motor, we have seen. So torque is directly proportional to the current for majority of the motor. So here we have again one assumption we have making for the equivalent torque method, that the torque is proportional to the current and irrespective of the motor. And for that we have taken an example of DC separately excited motor, for what? For this motor torque is proportional to IA. So if it is so, then the way we have determined IEQ, similar T equivalent equals to T1 square, small t1, capital T2 square, T2, so on up to n terms. Similarly, time is for time. The same thing is true. Now, this is nothing but the RMS value of the torque. Okay. So this is my torque. Now, when motor operates nearly fixed speed, its power is directly proportional to the torque. Power is directly proportional to the torque when speed is constant. Okay. For constant speed operation, if it is not constant speed, for variable speed, P is not proportional to T. But in this equivalent current, torque and power method, we have made certain assumption that for torque it is proportional to current, for power it is proportional to torque, and speed is constant. If it is so, then we can write that P equivalent equals to the way we have determined I equivalent, T equivalent. So P equivalent equals to this root over of combination of P1 square T1 up to nth term divided by up to time nth term Tn up to Tn. So this is all about equivalent current torque power method for fluctuating and intermittent load. Okay. So now we will solve some problem. Okay. So let me solve some problem. We have deduced this equivalent torque. We have deduced this equivalent power. Now let me solve this problem. A rolling mill driven by thyristor converter fed DC motor operates on a speed reversing duty cycle. Motor field current is maintained constant at a rated value. Moment of inertia referred to the motor shaft is 10,000 kg meter square. So what is my J? My J is 10,000 kg meter square. This is my J. Okay. Now, what we have to determine? We have to determine the torque. We have to determine the torque and power rating of the motor. Okay. So we know that we are concerned about DC motor. We are using here rolling mill is driven by a thyristor converter fed DC motor. Okay. And the speed reversal from 200 to minus 200 RPM in 5 seconds. Speed reversal taken from 200 RPM to minus 200 RPM. Okay. So, what is the torque during this speed reversal? This since DC motor is a constant fed current, the torque is proportional to armature current. We have taken the assumption torque is proportional to current just few minutes back. Okay. So, what is my torque during reversal? What is my torque during reversal? It is J d omega by dt, and J is nothing but 10,000, and d omega mean change in speed. Change in speed is from 200 to minus 200. So the change in speed is 200 minus minus of 200, and in the dt period is in 5 seconds. So divided by 5. So from here we will get the maximum torque, value of the torque during reversal, which is my maximum torque. So it will become, if we calculate this, 83,776 Newton meter. Now I have to determine TRMS. So what is my TRMS? For TRMS, I will use the formula that root over of T1 square. Root over of this formula I will use, that root over of T1 square, T1 plus T2 square T2. I will use this formula. I will use this formula for determination of, for determine the equivalent torque. Okay. So if we do, so let's see. Sorry, the solution is not here, so let me do the solution by myself. Okay. So what is my TRMS? TRMS is nothing but root over of T1 square T1 plus T2 square T2 plus dot 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 plus Tn square Tn divided by T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus dot 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 Tn. Now from the problem, let me see what is that value of T1 square T1. Okay, then T2 square T2, then T3 square T3 in this fashion. So if we see the problem, so at a constant torque 25,000 Newton meter for 10 seconds. So my T1 is 25,000 and small t1 is 10 second. So it is become, it will become 25,000 square into 10 plus, let me check another torque. So another torque is my this when the speed reversal from 200 to minus 200, and that time we have determined the torque is 83,776. Okay, so it will be into 83,776 for square for 5 minutes. Okay, plus is there any another torque? Let me check. Yes, rolling at full speed at a constant torque 20,000 newton meter for 15 seconds. Okay, so this is my third one. Is there any other torque? No. Okay, so it is my 20,000 square into 15, and total time is this 10, this 15, and let me check the problem. And is there any other talk? Speed reversal. First one is 25,000. I have taken that. For speed reversal, I have taken maximum speed reversal torque 83,706. For I have taken this torque 20,000 for 15 seconds. Is then yes. Again, there is speed reversal from minus 200 to 200. So this term will appear twice. Okay, so 5 seconds each, that means it will be plus 10. So 10 plus 10 plus 10, that is equals to my 35. Let me check another. Is there any another time? No load operation is for 1 second, so we will add 1. No load operation for 1 second, 2 seconds. Full load operation again 1 second, and no load operation again 1 second. So total time is again this plus 4. So this is 35 plus 4, so that is 39. So if we calculate this, we will get the value as 47,886 newton meter. Okay, now the torque, maximum torque is 83,776. That is the torque during the time reversal, that is the speed reversal, because speed reversal during the time of the speed reversal is maximum torque required. In normal operation is in my normal operation maximum torque is not required. So my T max is 83,776 newton meter, and my T rated is 47,886. Okay, so what is my lambda? Lambda is my T max 83,776 by 47,886. So it will become around approximately 2 times, 1.7 times, because if we multiply to 94, so it's almost 1.7. So if motor rating is chosen to be 47,486 newton meter, so if we choose this is my rated torque, so what will be my current rating? My current rating will be, that is my I max equals to will be 1.7 times of I rated. Thus, from here we are getting lambda dash equals to 1.7, and we have assumed that torque is proportional to current. So maximum current will also be 1.7 times I rated. Okay. So that is not a problem, because DC machine can drop twice the rated current in transient operation. So motor can be rated equal to TRMS. So my T rated is this 47,886. So what is my power rating? My power rating will be power equals to torque, that is rated torque 47,886 into omega, that is 2 pi n. So 2 pi and my n is, let me check my n. My n is rolling at full speed at 200 rpm. So it is rpm, so it is 200 divided by 60 rps. So if we simplify this, it will become 998.7 kilowatt. So we will get the power rating, we have determined the current rating. So this is my problem number 1. Okay. So, this is my problem number 2. A constant speed drive has a following duty cycle. Load rising from 0 to 400 in 5 minutes. Uniform load of 500 kilowatt 5 minutes. Regenerative power 400 kilowatt returned to the supply 4 minutes. Remain idle for 2 minutes. Estimate the power rating and losses of the to be proportional to the power square. Losses is proportional to the power square. So this is, they have told, assume losses to be proportional to the of the power square. Now what is my rated power? What is my P rated? It is nothing but P RMS value. Okay. Now RMS value for RMS value for of the power in the interval 1, that is for this interval, it is E1 equals to root over of 1 by T, T is 5 second, okay, integration of 0 to 2, 0 to 5, P square, that is 400 by 5, because we have seen that P equivalent equals to nothing but root over of P1 square T1 plus P2 square T2 plus dot 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 Pn square Tn divided by T1 plus T2 plus Tn. So this equals to into 1 by T 0 to 5 P square dt. So it will be into T square into dt, because proportional to the power square. So 400 by 5 T, that square. Okay. So if we do the integration, it will become 400 by root 3 kilowatt. Now I have to determine the PRMS, and PRMS is nothing but this formula. So what is my PRMS? So what is my P1? P1 is this instant, the RMS value is 400 by root 3. So 400 by root 3 square into T1, that is 5. My P2 is 500 for 5 minutes. So 500 square into 5 plus 400 kilowatt, 400 square for 4 minutes, okay, under root, this is all under root, and divided by T1 is my 5, 5, 10, 4, 14, 2, so divided by 16, okay. So here we have taken the RMS value because load is rising from 0 to 400 kilowatt, so that's why we have to determine the RMS value, and by default these are the RMS values. So if we simplify this, it will become 367 kilowatt. And what is my maximum power is here 500 kilowatt. Okay, So and rated is 367 kilowatt. Okay, so the motor rating is 367 kilowatt. Okay, so this is all about today's class. So these are the few reference which we have used in electrical drives. Thank you.